Hi everyone, this is Dr. Madhuri from Team MDS Concur. So in this video, we'll see about the neural crest cells, important for the finish line paper 1. So this neural crest cells, they are pluripotent cells and they are unique to the vertebrates, okay? And in this mammalians, actually in avians, they will separate this in the mammalian embryo, this cell separate from the lateral aspect of the neural folds, okay, but not the neural crest. But even though it is named as neural crest cells, but if you see, this thing is reversed in the avians, and in that also the neural crest cells are seen. But you have to remember, they are the transient pluripotent cells, and you can see here, these are the neural crest cells. So, coming to the induction of the neural crest cells. So, during the induction, this neural crest cells will undergo an epithelial and mesenchymal transformation. Okay. After that, their cell adhesive properties and cytoskeleton organization will change, allowing them to delaminate and migrate away from the neural tube. And this presumptive epidermis will secrete the bone metamorphic proteins 4 and 7, and these will induce the expression of the slug protein and RHOB, and this slug protein will activate the factors that dissociate the junctions between the cells, and all these together facilitate the cell dissociation from the neural tube and initiate the migration of the neural crest cells. Then coming to the migration of neural crest cells. So this migration of this is controlled by and control and proteins which promote this migration are laminin, fibronectin, tenascin, various collagen molecules and proteoglycans. And other set of proteins will embed migration and provide the specificity for cellular movements. Example, efferin proteins, and these proteins are present in the posterior aspect of the sclerotoma, and hence the neural crest cells cannot pass through this thing. And coming to the derivatives of the neural crest cells, and this neural crest cells will have four types of derivatives, that is cranial neural crest cells, cardiac neural crest cells, trunk neural crest cells, and vagal and sacral neural crest cells. So you can see here, this is the sacral crest, this is the vagal crest, and this is the cardiac crest, and here you can see the neural crest, cranial neural crest cells. Coming to the cranial neural cells, these cells will migrate dorsolaterally to produce craniofacial mesenchyme. So this craniofacial mesenchyme will differentiate into cartilage, bone, cranial neurons, glia and connective tissues of the face, whereas other few will migrate dorsolaterally, and few also enter the pharyngeal arches and pouches and give rise to the thymic cells, thyroid, parathyroids, dental papilla, pedial cementum and bones of middle ear and the jaw. So in hindbrain, again, the crest cells originate from the segmented regions are known as rhombomeres. So there are 8 segments in the hindbrain. So you can see in this diagram. So R1 and R2 are derived from the first arch, R4 from the second arch, R6 and R7 from the third arch, whereas R8 from fourth and sixth arch. And again, they can give rise to neurons and neuroglia, smooth muscle cells, calcitonin producing cells, melanocytes, adipocytes, tendon connective tissue cells, mesenchymal cells, fibroblast, cementoblast, chondroblast, osteoblast and osteocytes. Then coming to the cardiac neural crest cells, this cardiac neural crest cells form the endothelial linings of the aortic arches and also forms the septum between the aorta and divides the truncus arteriosus. Then this cardiac neural crest cells develop into the melanocytes, neurons, cartilage or connective tissue of 3rd, 4th and 6th pharyngeal arches. Then coming to the trunk neural crest cells, this trunk neural crest cells will migrate in the dorsolateral part and also in the ventral pathway. So cells which migrate in the dorsolateral path will differentiate into the melanocytes, and the cells which migrate into the ventral pathway will get entrapped in the sclerotome and differentiate into a dorsal root ganglia, and those passing behind it differentiate into a sympathetic ganglia. Then coming to the vagal and sacral neural crest cells. So they forms the enteric nervous system, which is essential for the gastrointestinal function. So if that they ask about the neural crest cells, you can include your contents like basic introduction of the neural crest cells, and along then afterwards the induction of the neural crest cells, migration of the neural crest cells, and the four components of the neural crest cells. And along with that, you have to write, include in contents about the applied aspects also, which will be dealing in other video. Okay, these are the references for this video. Thank you for watching and happy learning with MDS Concord, Dr. Madhuri, Team MDS Concord.